Should Christians keep the Sabbath day holy? That's the question we're talking about in this video. So without further ado, let's go, let's go, let's get it. What is up? How you doing? How you living? Welcome back to another video. If you're new here, my name is Scotty Bruh, and my goal is to help you seek, know, and live biblical truth in all that you do. So, hey, if you're interested, follow me, subscribe, hit me up on any of my social media platforms, and hey, let's seek truth together. Let's get it. Christians today aren't required to keep the Sabbath day holy. And in this video, I'm gonna give you 5 reasons as to why. Number one, the Sabbath was a part of the Old Testament law which we are no longer under. In Romans 7 verses 4 through 6, the Apostle Paul says this: "Likewise, my brothers, you also have died to the law through the body of Christ, so that you may belong to another, to him who has been raised from the dead, in order that we may bear fruit for God." Verse 5, "For while we were living in the flesh, our sinful passions aroused by the law were at work in our members to bear fruit for death." Now this is key right here, verse 6. "But now we are released from the law, having died to that which held us captive." Let me read that again. "But now we are released from the law, having died to that which held us captive, so that we serve in the new way of the Spirit and not in the old way of the written code." And Hebrews 8:13 says, "In speaking of a new covenant, he makes the first one obsolete," he being Jesus. "And what is becoming obsolete and growing old is ready to vanish away." So the main thing to note about this is the Old Testament laws can be broken into 2 categories. You have the moral laws, which include things like don't lie, don't cheat, don't steal, things of that sort. And then you have ceremonial laws. And these include things like circumcision, sacrifices, dietary restrictions, keeping the Sabbath, and things like that. And so in the New Testament, under the New Covenant, we see the moral laws are being repeated. Jesus reaffirms, don't lie, don't cheat, don't steal, things of that sort. However, we have been freed from the ceremonial laws, which is why today we don't have to practice circumcision or don't have to uphold the dietary restrictions of the Old Testament, keep doing the sacrifices that they had to do, and that includes keeping the Sabbath too. We have been freed from those ceremonial laws. Secondly, the Sabbath law in the Old Testament was given to the Israelites and not to Gentiles like you and me. In Exodus 31 verse 13, God speaking to Moses, he says, "You are to speak to the people of Israel and say, above all, you shall keep my Sabbaths. For this is a sign between me and you throughout your generations, that you may know that I, the Lord, sanctify you." The reason why God had these ceremonial laws in place in the Old Testament was he was trying to set his people apart from the other nations. He wanted to show them that they were his chosen people, and he wanted them to do these things, do these ceremonial practices in order to show that they have been set apart and chosen by God. Thirdly, we can choose to obey the Sabbath, but we aren't required to. And if someone chooses to observe it, they can choose any day that they please. In Romans 14 verses 5 and 6, Paul says, "One person esteems one day as better than another, while another esteems all days alike. Each one should be fully convinced in his own mind. The one who observes the day observes it in honor of the Lord. The one who eats, eats in honor of the Lord, since he gives thanks to God, while the one who abstains, abstains in honor of the Lord and gives thanks to God." So if you've been convicted to still observe it, you can still observe it. But if you don't want to observe it, that's okay too. The main thing is whichever one you choose, do it in honor of God and to give thanks to Him. And fourthly, piggybacking off of that, if someone has been convicted to observe the Sabbath, those who haven't chose shouldn't judge them. And the same works for vice versa. If somebody chooses not to observe the Sabbath, those who still want to observe it and practice that, they shouldn't judge those who choose not to. In Colossians 2 verse 16, the Apostle Paul says, "Therefore, let no one pass judgment on you in questions of food and drink, or with regard to a festival or a new moon or a Sabbath." And so whichever one you choose, don't pass judgment on somebody because they choose to abstain or because they choose to practice the Sabbath. And lastly, number six, although we aren't required to observe the Sabbath today, the principles of rest shown at creation in Genesis 2 verse 2 should still be observed today. As Christians, we shouldn't work 24/7, but should make time in our day, in our week, to reflect on and with God. At the end of Matthew chapter 11, Jesus talks about how He is Lord of the Sabbath. And He talks about how the Sabbath was a picture of Him. Jesus was saying He is our rest, and not our rest from manual labor, from our day-to-day job, but from our works of self-righteousness. So when Jesus says, "Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest," He's saying, if we're tired of trying to keep the laws and rules in order to get into heaven, we need to come to Him, because Jesus is Lord of the Sabbath, and He will give us rest. That is it for this video. Reflection question for you. What are your thoughts on Christians keeping the Sabbath today? Should they or should they not? And also let me know, do you still keep the Sabbath today? Let me know down in the comments down below. Thank you so much for checking out this video. I pray that you continue to seek, know, and live biblical truth in all that you do. Scotty bruh. And until next time, grace, peace. Secondly, the Sabbath law in the Old Testament was given to the Gentiles. Oh, that's the telephone ringing. Time out real quick. We're gonna let this guy ring. Somebody's calling the phone. It's 2020. I'm living it, and my dad still uses a home phone. Like, what? What are you doing, bro? Get with the times, man. Still going, bro. Still going.